Welcome back to the course, Privacy and Security in Online Social Media, Week 2. I hope you are participating in the online forum that we have in the course. I already see a lot of people asking questions and trying to answer. My sincere request would be, please read the posts before you actually ask the question. That is, read the post that has been already asked, questions that have already been asked, and the answers that has been already given before asking the question. And please participate also in the online forum, not just only asking questions. If you know the answers for the questions that others are asking, please try and answer them also. I hope most of you got to see the assignment one that we had posted. So I think the weekend of the week two is the deadline for the assignment one. Please try to work it out. The assignment one is actually pretty simple. It just captures some questions from the slides that we did and some from the tutorials. So let me just give you a quick summary of what we have seen until now, and then I'll go ahead with the topics that I wanted to cover today. So first we saw what social media is, different types of social networks, different types of content that gets generated on a social network, which is classical online social media services, and then some which are more like ephemeral social networks and anonymous social networks. We also saw what online social media means in 60 seconds. So how much of data is getting generated on social media in 60 seconds. We saw 400 hours of videos uploaded on YouTube and 3.3 million posts are done on Facebook and things like that. This basically shows us a large amount of content that are getting generated on online social media services. We also saw what four or five E's of online social media are. They are volume, velocity, veracity, variety, and value. Those are the five V's of online social media. And then I looked at, I showed you some events where online social media has played an important role in the real world and in the society also. Telling you about different issues on online social media. For example, in this case, it's compromised account. An account was compromised where the post said two explosions in White House and Barack Obama injured. And there was after effects of this tweet. So we looked at different issues that were happening on online social media, compromised account, fake content in this case, an image of a crocodile on the streets of Chennai while Chennai floods was going on in December 2015, caused panic among citizens. And there's also people who lose jobs and other issues because of usage of online social media. In the week one, we also covered a little bit about Linux and Python. Hopefully, you're all set in terms of using the platforms because I think there were some questions about can you use Windows. You should be able to use Windows and do programs on Python, but it just said our support will be mostly on Linux. And of course, learning Linux will also be good for you. So what I want to cover today is a couple of things. One, I want to actually look at different frameworks or platforms that you would get to know while doing this course, or in another terms, you should know while doing this course and collecting data from online social media, analyzing and making inferences. We look at what an API is, different types of APIs that are available for Facebook and Twitter. Then we'll also look at programming language, where there has been a tutorial on Python, so I'll just quickly go over. In any case, my goal for this week 2.1 about these topics are only generally to introduce, and then we'll have tutorials which are specifically focused on some of them. Then we look at programming languages, and then we'll also look at a little bit of database, how this data is stored, what kind of format of the data that is coming out, and a little bit about visualization too. So first, API, which is Application Programming Interface. This basically enables you to interact with online social media programmatically and collect data from them. What does this mean? This basically means that you can actually have a tunnel that is from your program to the social media services to collect data. It just creates a tunnel between your program and the online social media services, where you're going to ask some data, and then the social media service is going to respond with saying, here is the data that you asked for, right? So in particularly in our case, we will actually look at APIs for Facebook and Twitter, which will help you to collect data from Facebook and Twitter. There are other APIs also. All other social media services, or majority of the social media services, provide you with an API. We can't cover everything in this course, so we're going to target looking at only the most popular ones, or the ones that we can actually use for this course, which will help you to understand how APIs work, what data can be collected, so you can actually do it for other social media services yourself. So one of the important things that you want to also keep in mind is that about the rate limit, which is that in social media services, when you want to collect data, you cannot collect the data, everything that is available on social, on these services, because I'm sure the companies don't want to give you all the data also. They have set it up in a way saying that they have a rate limits for every social media service and every piece of data that you want to collect from them. So we look at something in the tutorials about rate limits, particularly about each of the social media API. But I wanted to just give you an idea about there is going to be a rate limit in terms of the data that you collect from these services. Also then, Python, since you've already done a tutorial on Python, I'll keep it really short. It's basically a programming language that is used to collect data, and it's one of the popular languages currently used in terms of writing API queries to the social media services. And it also has a lot of libraries for reading URLs, parsing data, interact with API, understanding the JSON objects and things like that. So data format, so particularly the API, when you send a request to Facebook saying that please give me all the data about the friends that PK has, or about the date of birth of PK, or about my friend's network. So what it is going to give you back is actually, it is going to give you in some format, one of the format that it gives you is actually a JSON format, which we'll see in brief what does this format mean, and how we actually interpret the data that is coming back from Facebook or Twitter. XML, which is also a format which some social media services give, or the JSON is also a little bit of like an XML, which is extended markup language. So here's what JSON means. JSON means JavaScript Object Notation, which is the data that you get back from the social media services. So here's an example that I have in this slide, which just shows you about the JSON object that is returned when you're asking for ID and name of a particular user. So in, this is a graph API Explorer, which you will see in the tutorial in more detail, but it's essentially through web browser, you can actually look at the data, look at the JSON objects of the Facebook data of yourself, of some whatever the Facebook API allows. You should be able to see it through this graph API. So again, let me emphasize, JSON is a JavaScript object notation, which is the way that the data is stored in Facebook, the data is stored in Twitter. When you request through the API for saying, give me this data about PK, it is returning the data in JSON format. It's basically a format that most social media services use today. So when you take the data from JSON, and when you want to interpret the data that is available in this JSON, data that is coming back from Facebook or Twitter, you can actually use json.viewer.stack.hu. This is only for you to see it visually, what data is coming back. You can take the data that is coming out of Facebook, copy-paste it into this JSON viewer, and you will be able to see what the each fields are. When you look at the data that is coming back from Facebook, it is generally a blob of data. It is just a lot of data that comes back. So you can actually take it and put it into JSON viewer to see what are the fields that it is actually giving you. We'll go through this slowly when we do the tutorials. And of course, when you collect the data, so first is API, which is a way by which you want to collect the data, and the data is coming back in JSON. When you collect the data, you have to store it in some format, right? So the format that majority of the times the data is stored is in MySQL. Basically, it is a relational database to store data, and data is stored in rows and columns, and simple queries you could use to get the data. For example, in this case, I've just done select user ID, user screen name, from the data that has been collected from Facebook. Right. So that helps, meaning, and again, I'm emphasizing that this is not a course on MySQL itself. We will only look at some simple queries, how to collect, how to look at the data that you have actually stored through the programs that you have written. MongoDB is one of the popular ones. More recently, we have started looking at, and people are actually using this. So MongoDB is another way by which the data is stored in, the data that is collected from Facebook is actually stored. So again, let me emphasize, which is API, then there is programming language, then there is MySQL database or MongoDB, which is data is coming through an API, collected and dumped into this MySQL or MongoDB. So now you also need a way by which to look at the data that is being stored. So one of the way you could use is actually PhpMyAdmin, which actually allows you to look at the data that you have in your own database. RoboMongo, so MySQL, PhpMyAdmin can look at the data from MySQL, and RoboMongo will help you to look at the data from MongoDB. So essentially, these are the ways by which you can collect the data, store the data, and look at the data that is available with you. So this is another view of RoboMongo, which shows you what are the different fields that are available, what data is stored in those fields. All content on Facebook is actually stored in a graph format. That is, user, the friends that I would have, the pictures that I upload, the videos that I upload, and the status updates that I do, everything is actually a node in the graph. And every interactions, which is basically like the comments, likes, and things like that, becomes the edges in this graph. Facebook actually stores all interactions, all data that they have in the graph format. That's why the API that they have is also called as a graph API. Here is another view of the same message, which is all objects are stored as nodes in the graph, connections like friends, friendships, likes, or edges, and all nodes have a unique numeric ID, which is users, pages, and posts. And we've been talking mostly about users. We will later talk about also pages, which is one of the ways by which content can be generated on Facebook. In tutorials this week, you will actually look at in detail about what a Facebook API is, how do you actually create the secret key, what kind of authentication that you'll have to provide to Facebook in terms of collecting data, what data can be collected, and things like that.